messages all day long. You know, I've been pig picking and pig catering yesterday all day, and I am overwhelmed with stuff. I have got stuff coming out my ear, stuff to do. I bet I got over, I don't know. I can probably look. Let's see here. Okay. 22 voicemails yesterday. That's on a Saturday. 22 voicemails. I answered 9 calls yesterday, even though I was working. So in between stuff, I was able to answer 9 calls. And let me find my emails. 67 unanswered emails. 67 unanswered emails. So got a message. I think this came in yesterday. I'm not positive. It may have came in today. Let me tell you about this question. It's a great question. Okay. This is from, I don't have permission to say her name, so I'm going to abbreviate her name. And then you won't know who it is really. Cause I didn't ask her. I didn't, say anything, but I'm gonna call her Liz. All right. Liz says, hello, Ben. I'm going to get into the hot dog vendor business. I've been watching your videos, have your book, and I'm researching at this point. My issue is logistics, as in I live in a condo. So no garage to store the cart. I have to a Toyota Camry 2013. Do I need to get rid of this and get an SUV? I'm single. How heavy are the carts for me to hitch to the SUV? I'm not convinced that being in one spot, i.e. street eats, is the way to go. It might solve these issues of hauling the cart around, but doesn't seem very fun, although I could be wrong. What is your counsel on these things? Thanks so much, Ben, for your time and kindness in helping your fellow humans out. Go weenies. All right, Liz. Good questions. Okay, first, don't need to get an SUV. We have vendors pulling the big dog. We have, I have a brand new vendor pulling the Cater Pro with a Harley Davidson. Well, it's a Goldwing motorcycle, right? So do you need, I mean, you're talking about a hitch weight or a tongue weight, they call it tongue weight of, 200 pounds, I think is the max. So can you pull it with a Camry? Absolutely. And let me tell you a little secret. You know, you may not have a tongue or a hitch set up on your Camry. You can go to U-Haul. U-Haul actually installs those. And for the cheapest price that I know of anywhere, they'll install a rated hitch for your vehicle, give you the tow amount, tow weight, everything. You won't have to worry about nothing. They'll even install the light hookup. Okay. And it's cheap. It's cheap. They put the tow bar on. They do it all for you. I am not affiliated with them. I don't make anything off of them. I'm just telling you. Okay. So next, you're in a condo. Let's see here. Yeah, condo. I live in a condo, so no garage to store the cart. So what do? You got to store your cart somewhere, right? You may have a friend with a business. You may have a, you could go get a storage unit, you know, for, I mean, I've seen storage units for $17 a month and I've seen them on up. Some condo places have a lot where you can put in a metal building, like, you know, one of these prefab metal buildings you have delivered. But ultimately the most common is to go to like a mini storage, and you just put your cart there. I've got vendors that are using the mini storage as their commissary because they put in a sink. Some mini storage come with a water. So you could put in a sink and put in your fridge and pass it as a commissary. We've had vendors on the show that talked about that. So no, don't spend any more money other than a place to store your cart. That's it. And you're talking cheap. So you don't need to spend a lot of money to get going. Now, as far as street eats, absolutely not, because street eats doesn't allow you to store your cart. Just because you're with Street Eats and you're at Lowe's or Home Depot doesn't mean you can store your card at Lowe's and Home Depot. So some managers will let you, but most of the ones that we've talked about on the shows and videos, they had to get their own container to put this card in. So I wouldn't do that. I mean, there'd be no, to me, there'd be no logic behind that. Liz, that's it. I hope that makes sense. Jason has been sick. Hope you're feeling better, brother. Glad to see you're back, though. And I love the hat. Love the freaking hat. Corey's in the house. Thanks for being here, Corey. Anyway, if you have, hey, look, Greg Boyd's here. Dang, I didn't even look at the thing. I have to go to another page to see who's here. And then I can't see the video. And, you know, your ego, you want to see yourself for whatever reason. I could go get a mirror, I guess, and put it up and then watch myself. But you want to make sure, I guess, that it's working. Troy says, hey, team, glad you're feeling better, Jason. Great, Troy. Thanks for the kind words to Jason. And we've got some exciting stuff. What do y'all see today? Okay. At, I'm going to go ahead and spread the news a little bit. You know, we've been doing this free training thing, right? We've been doing this free training thing where you can come train for free. You don't have to spend any money other than just to get here, okay? And train on a real cart, not like in some back parking lot. Let me show you how to use my cart. I'm talking live with customer interaction, right? With a pro vendor, somebody that's in our Vendors United group, okay? We're fixing to add two more states, possibly three, that you can do that in. So you'll be able to pick. You'll be able to go, oh, I'd rather be in, you know, near to Florida, or I'd rather be near to Virginia or whatever. You'll be able to pick and go to and set up an appointment absolutely free. And then here's the only, that, you know, a lot of people say, what's the catch? What's the catch? There's no catch. Okay. But I'm going to give you your travel expenses back if you buy a cart. But what if you don't buy a cart? Do you get, is there a bill? Nope. I'm just helping you out. You could go buy a used cart. You could build your own cart. You could do whatever you wanted. And I'm going to make it easier for you to work with a vendor of your choice. Okay. So we've got some cool stuff coming in the next 2 weeks. That's going to be, exciting and an awesome opportunity for you to work with a real vendor, including myself. I'm including myself. You'll be able to come work with me on a live cart, work with me at one of my gigs or something. Okay. So, and for free. Now, I want you to look back. If you don't believe me, I got so busy doing gigs, I was charging up to $5,000 a day, because it is a pain in the neck to have somebody with you all day. It is. I can't tell you. And it's not that everybody's a pain in the neck. Sometimes you get people that are a pain in the neck to work with. You know, they're in your way. They constantly, they say the wrong thing in front of customers that you're working with. So it gets to be a pain in the neck sometimes. Well, I quit doing it because, one, I was overwhelmed and in so many requests. When I first came out with my book, Hot Dog Saved My Life, I had so many people that wanted to come and work with me, and I was just doing it free. Well, then I got overbooked, and I was like, okay, I'm going to charge for it. And then I quit, and then I got – and when I say I charged $5,000, what happened is I had people offer me – I didn't have the service anymore, and they offered to pay me to come. And I did, I believe, two or three of those. Then recently, and you can ask Matt Gladfelder about this. We were offered $25,000 to help a vendor. He wanted the whole kit and caboodle, us to show up, train, work with him for a couple days, and $25,000. I thought it was a waste of money, and I even told the guy, this is a waste of money. You're wasting your money. Everything I have is online. Now, is there a value to go work with a vendor and work with that vendor through the day? Yes. Yes, huge value. I'm talking cut years out of your learning curve. Go straight to the point. You'll be able to start instantly. I want you to be successful. So what I've done is set it up where it doesn't cost you nothing except your travel cost. Now I'm setting it up so that I can make it more available to people that don't have the ability to travel to Knoxville, Tennessee with Matt, okay, with bow ties. I'm going to set them up in multiple states. We have it already scheduled, so you'll see other states coming soon, right? In the next 2 weeks, you'll have two new states coming. You'll be able to pick one of those states and go, oh, this is closer to me. I'd want to work. Now, does that mean you have to go to the closest one? No, but it's free. You go work with them and there's no catch. There's no gimmick. You just work with them. If though, my mind sometimes doesn't work correctly. I'm getting older. It's like a bribe, but it's a ethical bribe. There's the word, ethical bribe. Here's my ethical bribe. I will pay for your trip up to $300 if you buy a cart from me. Now, do I change the price of the carts? Nope. Not a dime. You just get an extra $300 off because you did the training. Now, why would I do that? Because I want to see you successful. Do you think that right now I could quit working, you know, quit doing training and all that stuff and live? Absolutely, I could. I could sell carts without doing all this. I absolutely enjoy teaching, sharing, doing this stuff. Absolutely. Now, do I make money off my courses and stuff? Yes, yes, yes. But my business is selling carts, right? And I sell carts and it works. And whether I was doing training and all these Facebook lives and Twitter and Instagram, and now I've got whatever the Snapchatty thing is. And I think that's what it's called. It's not Snapchat, is it? Hold on. Now it aggravates me. See, WhatsApp. See, wasn't even Snapchat. WhatsApp. Doing the WhatsApp. Then I started the vending again. I'm vending again. Okay. And one, because I miss it, and I'm having fun. I mean, I did one yesterday. I don't know if y'all saw it. I broadcasted live. I'm having a freaking blast doing this stuff. It wasn't WhatsApp, was it? Snapchat. Heather just told me Snapchat. I was wrong. Dadgum. Heather keeps me straight. I am doing this stuff and having fun helping you, but I get a reward. Don't think I don't. My reward, my ego is fed by this stuff. So don't think, oh, Ben is some kind of saint. Nope, nope, nope. You don't think that when I get, and you can ask Heather, she goes through my emails, okay? You can ask Heather, when I get these positive raving reviews, Ben, you didn't, like we got one recently, you didn't, hot dogs didn't save my life, you saved my life. Do you think my head doesn't swell? Are you kidding me? I'm freaking human as the next guy. My head swelled like a freaking pumpkin. The extra large pumpkins. So, sitting in the sun pumpkin, I'm talking swelled up. I love it. I love seeing these results. And if you aren't, well, I know there's people listening right now that are in the Vendors United group, but if you're not in there, you'd see the people that post and the changes they're making and things they're doing. And when they ask for an opinion, like we had a vendor today ask for an opinion on a logo. We're not brutal, but we're honest. And we go, nope, that sucks. Do this, or change this, change that. Or consider this, consider that. There's no tippy toe and eggshell around it. We help each other become better. And that is a beautiful thing. I'm glad you're here and I'm glad you're a part of this. But if you have any desires to move on, and better yourself, consider joining Vendors United. It's $27 a month. Okay, that wasn't the intention of this video. My intention was to help Liz with her question. And Heather, if you don't care to put this video link to Liz and the messages thing, because that's who I'm answering. Anyway, I hope that helps y'all. I hope you're having a great day. I get to go because I was too lazy last night to, when I got back from this pig picking, I was too lazy to clean everything. So I scooped out everything and bagged it up, but I didn't clean the roaster or nothing, which is a no-no. And so I get to do that today. And it was supposed to be sunny today, and I posted up earlier that it's raining. So Liar Bob, my weather guy, I don't call them meteorologists. I just call them liars. This is Liar Bob with your forecast, because I've never known a profession you can be more wrong in more often and still be called a meteorologist. Like it's something I went to school and I learned how to predict the weather. It's kind of like somebody who predicts Ouija board movements or lottery numbers or freaking lottery numbers, you know, like shaking it. Oh, that's going to be, oh, there's going to be a 23 in there somewhere. Weather people I know it's not a science. As far as I know that there's no way to know that possible changes, but, I don't like the credibility we give weather people because they're more often wrong than right. And I've got a dear friend that works for the Weather Channel in Atlanta, Georgia. And, they're wrong. They're just wrong. Most of the time they're wrong. And so today is supposed to be sunny and it's raining. It's nasty. Anyway, let me check these things, make sure I didn't. Weather guy and baseball players, only guys who keep their job with a 250 average. Love it. Love it, Mark. Heather says pumpkin pie. Frankenstein's in the house. Thank y'all for being here. Guess what? Heading out tomorrow. I may catch Frankenstein's again. Heading across. I'm going to try to catch crazy dogs. Going to try to catch some vendors in Nashville area, Tennessee. Going to try to catch some vendors in Arkansas and in Missouri. In the next week, I'm hoping to catch a bunch of vendors. And I'll be broadcasting live, so stay tuned for it. I look forward to it. If you're interested at all in joining Vendors United and getting a heads up, there's no contract, no press hard 3-copy deal. You can quit at any time. It's $27 a month. It's dirt cheap. Ask anybody in there if they'd be willing to pay a lot more, and they would. Go to learnhotdogs.com/join and at least watch the video and find out what it's about. learnhotdogs.com/join. Thank you for being here. Love you. Hope you have a rest of your weekend is great, and I'll talk to you later.